our universes behind the mirror. Our job is to replicate what actual humans do. Functional mirrors were a great idea, but they never really worked out. Our job is to help what you humans call reality. And that's why we came up with this venture. Every one of our employees replicates the actions of an actual person. Now that's what they want us to tell you. But what you don't know is that we're the ones who are teaching people how to behave. So the next time you look into the mirror, ask yourself, who's copying who?
Seriously, you need to chill before I kill you. We know what you did.
I didn't do anything, man. Please, please, please. Just leave me alone. Please, I can give the money in like just a week, please.
I'll give you one more chance, cutie.
No, you know what you did, and now you have to pay with your life.
What do we do with him now? Oh, we could turn him into a mannequin.
How do you even do that?
I have an idea. We can cut his bangs so he's unrecognizable.
That's a good idea.
What's
Do we need a doctor?
Yes, I'm sick. You guys knew that when you tagged me along. I feel like I'm about to pass out. I need to go to the hospital.
There's someone coming! Guys, quick, move the body! Come on. Okay. Jelly, grab the leg while I grab the arms.
Okay. You're a waste of a man.
Ew, his hands are all slimy.
Why are they so heavy?
Ew, no, somebody else do it. I'm not picking them
up. Yeah, you go. Christ. Sarah, you do it.
We would have never been in this situation if Ari wouldn't stop sneezing on everybody.
Hey, don't try to pin the blame on me. Let's talk about Samara, how she doesn't know how to dispose of a body the right way.
I killed him, unlike Amaris, who only plays with her mannequin.
At least I actually kill, unlike George, who just flirts with everybody.
Ash, you look it beautiful. Just look at you.
Well, at least I'm not doing my job properly, unlike a miracle.
Why am I in this? Elle messed up the body, too.
Hey, you know what? Okay, let's just pick him up. Let's go.
This is disgusting.
Y'all, let's go before we get caught.
Wait, oh, there's something coming. Wait, he's moving. His feet wiggled.
Ew.
Pick him up, Ew.
Come on, we gotta go. There's someone coming.
Okay, so first of all, you guys really suck at killing, and I'm just going to go now.
He just...
Am I just...
Why are you running?
So, buffet?
Sure.
To be continued!
McAllister Ford, Roma Santiago, Westcott and Johnson Law Offices.
Does your family steal your dino nuggies?
My family always steals food off my plate, so I call McAllister, Roma Santiago, Westcott, Johnson Law Offices. Where's my paycheck? I'm an orphan.
Have you ordered food and they wanted you to tip the driver?
I'm here. I'm just a crippled driver.
Does your mafia always fail a hit?
Kill them or just ding cute.
Call 7979. Your life is on the line. I repeat.
Hey, I'm here. I made it just one time.
You're on the wrong set.
Oh, I'm late. I'm sorry. You guys told me to be here at 9 o'clock and it's 10:57. I have to hurry up. Are we ready? Am I on?
Okay, starting 5, 4, 3.
Hi, my name is Dr. Schwitz. Have you realized your peanuts aren't crazy? They've just been going nuts all these years? Or is your name Medusa and your husband just won't look you in the eyes? Well, that really sounds like a personal problem and it's not our problem to deal with, but we may have a problem to your solution. A solution to your problem. Introducing the bonker. It's really therapeutic, and even I use it, and there's nothing wrong with me. There's nothing wrong with me at all. I'm not crazy. But here are a few examples of our happy customers who have purchased the bonk.
Now to... to a few people who have used the bunk and found it very useful. First is Ava Schwabe.
Arskinarba, Yaba.
Next is Morgan
Arskinoiba. Oh, Arshka.
Ick. Kind, Belina. Helpful.
Thank you, Morgan. Next, fortunately, have someone here in person who have used the bonk. Next is Amaris Knox. Go ahead. Come here.
Somebody please help me. They kept me here for I don't know how long.
I'm so sorry about that, ladies and gentlemen. That was a few stray cats in the back. You guys know how those alley cats be. But if you would like to purchase our wonderful bonker, make sure you call. Again, I don't remember the number, but you should because you wrote it down. The bonker.
The bonk. Not in your local stores.
Did you just hit one of your customers? And why is she lagging in the back?
No.
Hey, no one's lagging.
Why are you eating a steak?
Because I brought it with me and I didn't want to bring marshmallows like the rest of you losers.
Ugh, it's boring. Somebody do something.
Oh, how about I tell a scary story?
If it's about food, tell her.
Okay.
No, but anyways, once there was a scary ostrich on the loose. He was known for pecking everybody's eyes out.
He pecks eyes out? What are you?
Wait, those aren't your real eyes?
Ugh. Of course they're not.
Anyways, about 5 years ago, there was a group of teens sitting at this exact campfire. Legend has it, the ostrich would rise from the fire and peck everybody's eyes out.
What's an ostrich?
Oh, be quiet. No, one has seen the ostrich since.
Until now.
No, like seriously, what's an ostrich? Is it like his maiden name?
It's a bird.
It's a bird.
The bird sounds really good right now. Really good.
What is that?
Wait. No one freak out. Guys, calm down. It's just an old homeless man.
Well, I hope you brought enough marshmallows because he's not getting any of my hot dog nor steak.
Oh, shut up. I bet you're hungry. Come with me. You can eat. Oh my God, did you just stab me? I'm gonna go viral on TikTok. Oh, can you take my picture and send it to my mom? Thank you. Guys, I think I'm gonna just lay right here and just go to sleep.
Okay, I'm out of here.
Birdman, can you like do me a favor since you killed my best friend? Can you be my boyfriend? I just went through a breakup and he cheated on me, so like we can fake a date so I can, you know.
Hi, have you seen Manny? No. Okay. Bye-bye.
I'm gonna hurry back to my tent. I gotta get my inhaler.
Oh no, my shoe's untied. Ouch! Hi, have you seen Manny?
Oh. Okay. Bye-bye.
I finally got away. Oh, no, not you again. Come on, I just got some alone time with my steak. I could fix you up a hot dog. What do you like? Ketchup, mustard, relish. Hey, hey.
Seven years of track, 3 years of wrestling. I can take you on. Come on, I got a game tomorrow. Stop.
Oh, dear Lord. Okay, look, you don't need to kill me, okay? I just want to say how ugly you are. Anyways, you killed 7, you don't need 8. I'll be back, okay?
Danny, there you are. I've been looking for you everywhere.
She was there! I'm not going to jail! No! No!
A long and stressful amount of time in court, my dear old friends ended up in the slammer. You know, the big house. Samara's time in prison was a lot more homey than any of us anticipated. She even became the leader of a new gang.
Okay, so at midnight, we're gonna jump these guards, shank them, and run.
Amaris started her own side gig with her partner Manny, making prison wine.
Manny, hurry up and start faster.
George ended up seducing and falling in love with all of the male prison guards and his cellmate, who ends up keeping him company at night. Alan Jelly tried to become the masterminds of escape, but every time they made an attempt, they forgot, like, major parts of the plan.
You're missing a spork.
I thought you said bring spoons. I brought the spoon. Now you say bring a spork. Oh, you know what? No. The guards are coming. Run!
Ari initially struggled with the food, with it being bland and just very small portions. But she eventually found her place working in the lunchroom, and she is living her best life.
Potatoes with that. Hey! Don't do that to that gravy. My grandmother made that. Have some respect.
I guess the prison life was just all too much for dear old Lily, and she ended up jumping to her death. R.I.P. Lil' Romer. Now, you may have heard of Morgan Bielik. Actually, you definitely haven't heard of him. He thinks he's a famous author, but no one has ever heard of him. And I mean no one. Don't tell him that, though.
Have they heard of my book outside of prison?
I heard he even got himself a lawyer.
No. No one has talked about you.
What do you mean?
I'm... Really?
Wow. But that's the up-and-coming writer.
Got out on good behavior. Now she's living her best life waiting for the rest of her crew. And me? Well, after I lost all this dead weight, I was able to become the successful criminal of my dreams. Don't need to look behind my back all the time now. Well, if you'll excuse me. Run!
Do 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 do.
For years in Milwaukee, Wisconsin, there had seemed to be no hope, no help, and no change.
Noon, a former Milwaukee police officer is now charged with reckless homicide for the deadly shooting of a black man.
A Milwaukee police officer shot and killed Dontre Hamilton, and frustration has grown for both the family and Milwaukee police.
Y'all took him away from his kids, his unborn baby.
Everybody on this block, they need to get along and put these guns down and stop all this killing that they do because it ain't worth it.
Because once again, the police has failed to protect us like they say they was going to do.
But then, in 2019, just as things were starting to go downhill, two students who attend Milwaukee High School of the Arts decided to try to change their reality. They wanted to have a positive impact on future generations. Andrea Hoppe and Matiana Hernandez started an ACLU club at their high school, hoping to make a difference
I thought it'd be really nice for a school to have kids come together and talk about social issues while still making a change.
They began to organize group meetings that would take place once a week where a variety of diverse students would get together to discuss the issues that needed to be dealt with in our country in the hope to make a difference in their community.
I just want to bring a sense of awareness through spreading education.
On their own initiative, the group began to organize protests, which would take place all over Milwaukee. These protests would fight against gun violence as well as racial and gender discrimination. Even through a deadly virus such as COVID-19, nothing was going to get in the way of these young community leaders. In fact, the challenges only served to fuel the ambitions of the members who came together to make a difference. The group slowly grew into what it is now, over 30 students who speak to a better tomorrow. Bringing people together through protests built a sense of community among the citizens of Milwaukee. The leaders started a separate organization called Art Justice, where artists can come together in order to create art that communicates a message that inspires change. Today, the two leaders are a year away from graduating high school, and they are making sure that they are delivering their messages to the next generation of younger student activists to continue the process of activism for years to come at the Milwaukee High School of the Arts and beyond.
National parks are an area set aside by a national government to preserve the natural environment and wildlife. The creation of national parks provided protection for predators and prey, ranging from bears to rabbits to eagles and butterflies. Specifically in Yellowstone National Park, we'll be talking about the eradication of gray wolves and the reintroduction back into the Yellowstone Park and how that affected the environment. Gray wolves can be found all throughout North America. Most importantly, Yellowstone Park, located mostly in Wyoming, but ventures out into Montana and Idaho. Here, the gray wolves were thriving until their prey base was destroyed when agriculture flourished, this leading them to prey on the domestic stock. Humans not liking this led to them being hunted and eventually eliminated from Yellowstone. The last Yellowstone gray wolves were killed in 1926. The eradication of gray wolves in Yellowstone had devastating results. Once the wolves were gone, the elk population exploded. Even though Yellowstone elk were still being preyed upon by black bears, grizzly bears, and cougars, the absence of wolves took a huge amount of predatory pressure off of the elk. This being a problem because with the growth of elk meant more elk grazed their way across the landscape, killing young bush and trees like willow, which affected beavers since they needed willow to survive the winter. Not only did beavers need willow needed beavers. They needed the dams that beavers built to slow down the river's flow, which meant they could thrive. They both needed each other. Since beavers' resources were taken by the elk, you would see less of them. And then losing beavers meant you lost an ecosystem engineer. The less beavers meant the less dams were being built. Dams caused the flow of rivers to slow, preventing erosion on banks and creating an appropriate habitat for wildlife. With less dams came the lack of shallow marshes and other vegetation that grew near or on dams, which were fed on by many species, such as otters, fish, ducks, and many more. With fewer marshes meant that fewer species could feed. The loss of these species results in predators having less prey, destroying the food chain, the environment, and causing a disappearance of species and reducing biodiversity. People seen and studied these devastations, finding the loss of wolves were the cause of this devastation. Luckily, gray wolves were reintroduced. On January 12, 1995, a pack of wolves from Jasper National Park in Canada were relocated to Yellowstone, this making them the first pack of gray wolves to return to Yellowstone National Park. Bringing back the wolves struck a nerve among ranchers along the park's boundaries who feared the wolves would wander out the park and kill their livestock. But biologists felt the wolves played a key role in Yellowstone's ecosystem. Once the wolves returned, they brought down the elk population and protected open valleys from overgrazing. The wolves actually benefited not only themselves, but others as well. Scavengers that once relied on winter kill elk for food now depend on wolf kill elk. Scavengers such as ravens, eagles, magpies, coyotes, and both grizzly and black bears, especially as the bears emerged hungry from hibernation. As the wolves' hunting increased, the deer and the elk started avoiding certain parts of the park. These places started to regenerate, and tree growth has been seen to increase. Bear Valley sites, left behind by elk and deer, quickly became forest aspen, willow, and cottonwood. And as soon as that happened, the birds started moving in. The number of songbirds and migratory birds started to increase greatly. The number of beavers started to increase as well. And with that came the dams. The dams they built in the rivers have provided habitats for otters, muskrats, ducks, fish, reptiles, and amphibians. Additionally, the wolves killed coyotes. As a result of that, the number of rabbits and mice began to rise, which meant more hawks, more weasels, more foxes, and more badgers. Most importantly, the wolves changed the behaviors of the rivers. The rivers meander less, which meant less river cliffs. You would see less erosion and channels narrowed, which was a good thing because channels disrupted transportation, destroyed agricultural land, drastically altered environmental conditions, and produced sediment that would flow downstream and cause habitat loss and other problems. The regenerating forest stabilized the banks, so they collapsed less often. The rivers became more fixed in their course. With the reintroduction of gray wolves, the landscape of the whole park was transformed. These transformations has been undoubtedly beneficial at preserving Yellowstone Park for future generations. The park is now felt in balance, with the right mix of different stakeholders doing more of the right things with a greater level of control, process, and hierarchy, but also freedom, openness, and vibrancy to support ongoing change and adaptability. Protecting Yellowstone is important to protect the species living there, but also providing people a place to see natural processes and to use that throughout their life to make decisions on what they think is important. Gray wolves has shown us as humans how important balance is in the ecosystem, not only an ecosystem, in any system, and how animals work to innovate and make an ecosystem healthy and thriving.
I am. I've always felt a lot more feminine than all the other guys around me. I never really felt truly like a man.
I've noticed whenever I go to skate parks, I always get a lot of weird looks, especially from parents and kids.
I've noticed the respect I would get when I would wear feminine clothing would be a lot less. I've met a decent amount of people who are pretty accepting about all of it, most of them also queer or trans or LGBT. I remember the person who got me into the LGBT skate scene was actually Kane Cables. I found them on Instagram, and from there kind of opened me up to a whole new world. And since then I've actually met a lot of my favorite skaters like P and Marby. And
I feel so grateful to have found a community of other skaters who's accepting of me being gender fluid.
I'm a galactorator, one of a group of cosmic archaeologists.
We found some ancient artifacts in Sector 4B. So if you could go down there and take a look at it, that would be great.
Our job is to eliminate distracting objects that confuse our people. People need to have a clear focus. I'm a part of that mission. But maybe there's something more.